Hi, I've got a question here which you might like to try if you want to revise implicit differentiation. We've got this curve C which has an equation 16y cubed plus 9x squared y minus 54x equals 0. And what we've got to do is find dy by dx in terms of x and y. So if you haven't done this and you'd like to give it a try, just pause the video, come back when ready, and you can check your work solution with mine. Okay, welcome back if you had a go. So I'm assuming that you're familiar with implicit differentiation. If not, you can always go on my website, examsolutions.net, check out the tutorials on implicit differentiation. But briefly, when it comes to differentiating terms that are functions of y, we just use this principle that if you're differentiating some function of y with respect to x, we apply the chain rule. We differentiate the function of y with respect to y, and then we multiply it by dy by dx. It's as if these two dy's cancel one another out, leaving you with the differential of f of y over dx, what we have here. Okay, so before we start, I'm just going to copy down the question. So we've got 16 then y cubed plus 9x squared y minus 54x equals 0. And what I'm going to tell the reader is that I'm going to differentiate this, we'll just write diff for short, with respect to, okay, x. So we differentiate this equation here then with respect to x. So the first term is a function of y. So we use the principle here, implicit differentiation then. We differentiate this with respect to y and then we multiply it by dy dx. So if we differentiate this with respect to y, we're going to get 16 times the power 3, which is going to give us 48. So we end up with 48 y squared, okay, and then we multiply it by dy by dx. And then plus, now when we come on to this term, we've got a product of two functions, say the 9x squared multiplied by the y, the red part and the green part. So we have to do this by the product rule. So again, I'm assuming that you're familiar with the product rule for differentiation. So we take one part, let's say the red part, 9x squared, and we multiply it by the differential of the other part, the green part in this case, the y. Differentiating y with respect to x is just simply dy by dx. If we took it literally like this, we would differentiate the y, get 1, and then multiply it by dy by dx. Okay? But nonetheless, it's dy by dx. And then using the product rule, we plus, and then we take this part now, y, and multiply it by the differential of 9x squared with respect to x. Well, that's just going to simply be 18x. Okay? So we've done that part there. Just at this point, it's worth mentioning that if you get questions like this where you've got a minus here, take care, because you'd need to put these two terms inside a bracket, okay, so that that minus would then override this plus here, giving you a minus in the long term. Okay, now we move on to this next term here, minus 54x. Differentiate this with respect to x and you got minus 54, and equals, and if we differentiate the 0 with respect to x, well, that's still 0. Now what we need to do next is to group together the two dy by dx terms, and I'm going to add 54 to both sides, and this is 18xy when tidied up. I'm going to subtract 18xy from both sides. So for these two terms we would factorize as well. Try not to put dy dx at the front of your bracket though, okay? It generally is placed at the rear of the bracket. So what we've got here is 48y squared. This is 9x squared, so we've got plus 9x squared. And then it's usual to write dy by dx at the rear of this bracket. It wouldn't be wrong if you wrote this at the front, but this is just the general position that we write it. And then equals, and as I said earlier, we'll add 54 and subtract the 18xy. Okay, so we're nearly there. To get dy by dx, all I need to do is just divide by 48y squared plus 9x squared. So therefore we've got dy by dx equals, now that will be 54 then minus 18xy all over 48y squared plus 9x squared. And that's acceptable as an answer, okay? Now you could take this further. You should be able to see that we could factorize the top, and if we did do that, if we pulled out say 18, it goes into both 54 and the 18 here, it's a common factor, the highest common factor, we would end up with 18 times 3 to give us the 54, and then 18 times the minus xy to give us minus 18xy here. And we'll divide that then by 48, well, we got a common factor here actually. We got 3 that goes into 48 and 9. So let's just pull the 3 out. 3 bracket 16y squared, giving us the 48y squared, and then plus 3x squared. So we get 3 times 3x squared, the 9x squared. And you can see that we can cancel now the common factor of 3. So what we end up with is essentially 6 multiplied by 3 minus xy all divided by 16y squared plus 3x squared. So you can leave it either as this answer, it's quite acceptable in this question to leave it at this stage, or you could reduce it down as I've done here. You might not even want to factorize the top, just divide every term through by 3, and what you'd end up with is 18 here minus 6xy all over 16y squared plus 3x squared. Okay, so I hope it's given you an idea then across this question.